Hey there, my name is Magix, and welcome back to another MTGO Pioneer League with Blue White Control, where we have added, Fiend Slayer Paladin in our sideboard to slay the evil Matter Leader. So, stay tuned, and let's go! So guys, before we begin, some credits to the creator of this deck, which is Mr. Skura here, or Islands in Front. He has constructed this deck, he has even written a nice sideboard guide and explained every card in the deck. And yeah, the list is actually only 2 hours old by now, so it's pretty fresh. I liked his deck construction a lot and figured, while I was losing pretty badly in the last league with Grixis, why not refer to some of the experts in this format? And so if you like the deck afterwards, just add him on Twitter, I guess. So anyways, let's jump into this deck and let's see what do we have here. Well, blue-white control, of course, zero creatures in the main deck, so we are blanking every removal spell the opponent might play in this main deck. But if you followed my last video or even the meta in general, you'll see that we have three different decks at top right now. We have mono black aggro, mono red aggro, and mono green ramp. So three different mono colored decks, whereas two are being very aggressive, and one is trying to get over the top. And yeah, two of these out of these three decks destroyed us the last time. I was not prepared for them in my Grixis deck, and I think that white has better tools to at least fight the aggro decks. So what do we have here? Right in the counterspell department, you've got Absorb, which has the nice line of text that you gain 3 life as you counter a spell. So hopefully this will buffer up our life totals as we counter maybe a burn spell or even some of these nasty 3 mana goblins that were running all over us in the last league. And here, no more Quelches. I really hated Quelch. I liked the Syncopate, so I'm very happy to see 2 copies here. This one will scale up to the late game, since we are running 25 lands, and we want to get the game to drag out a little bit. Syncopate will become really strong. In the early game, it's still kind of fine to 4 spike for x equals 1, right? And what I also like about this counterspell is that it actually exiles the opponent's spell that is countered. So you can maybe even use it against a hard card Arclight Phoenix. And of course some spell pierces to survive early on. So this is our counter suite in the main deck. And yeah, since the top 3 decks are actually running out a lot of creatures, I think it should be fine to only run like 6 around here, because we have also several removal spells. We have 5 spot mass removal spells with 4 supreme verdicts that can't be countered. This can be important in some tempo matchups, but I guess until we face something like Izzet Phoenix or the blue-red and soul artifact deck that might run Stubborn Denial, I think the can't be countered isn't that important, but it's maybe the only really unconditional destroy all creatures in this format, since there is no damnation or something. So it's also of course very good against the mono green aggro deck that puts bigger creatures into play that you can't kill with the red spot removal, like Lightning Strike or Ferocious Strike or what have you. And yeah, Settle the Wreckage is a 5th copy as from the mass removals. It's a 5th mass removal in the deck. That's how I should call it. And since 2 of the top 3 decks are aggro decks, figure they will attack with creatures. In case of the Goblin Rebel Master, I think if I remember correctly, he has to attack. Let me quickly check this, but I'm sure from modern that this guy. Yeah, well, you try to search for goblin and write him wrong, and somewhere now is this rebel master. So yeah, probably with double B. Yeah, there he is. So no, he doesn't have to attack. So I'm talking bullshit right now. Never mind. I was probably misremembering that with the goblin that has protection from blue, but I guess that one is not played in those mono red decks. Anyways, yeah, but nonetheless, I think one settle as a fifth mass removal is nice. Again, if you face like an Arclight Phoenix deck, yeah, the Exile Clause can be relevant. If you face like the Dredge deck, this could be also like one of the only outs there. And I think there is even like a Bogles deck in this format. So trying to wreck their day, I'm all in for that. Then yeah, we have some nice spot removal. First off, we have Azorius Charm, which can put an attacking creature back on the opponent's yeah deck. Unfortunately, this will not prevent the goblin token that the Rebel Master or the other one with Mentor will create during the beginning of combat step. So it's also important to have these verdicts to clean up afterwards. But at least this is a really strong option against stuff like Monastery Swift Spear or Glory Bringer, right? All these hasty creatures and even the Mutawalls walls that are coming at us. Well, for only 2 mana, we can put them back on top. Doesn't matter how high their toughness is. So this is also nice again if you face like the mono green Stompy deck. It's also nice that you can put back like an Darksteel Citadel that was enchanted by Ensoul Artifact. You don't care about non-land here, so it's also good against these man lands. And yeah, if it's bad in the matchup because we are playing like a mirror match, well, there's always the line draw a card, right? Yes, it's no card selection. Yes, it's probably too expensive for drawing one card, but it's better than nothing. And yeah, it fills then up our graveyard to fuel out the dig through time that we have here. So I like it. And the first line of text can also become important, but only in postboard matchups. We will talk about this just in a second, because if we run Monastery Mentor and make some tokens in this deck, yeah, well, then if you face like an aggro deck and can give your little army lifelink, that will be huge. Could come up. It's maybe more borderline, but all in all, yeah, pretty good card. Because we had like Fatal Push in our Grixis deck, but we couldn't trigger Revolt regularly, and we had really trouble with getting rid of 3 and 4 mana creatures. And you can definitely solve this with the Azorius Charm here. You could maybe, of course, also find solutions in the Grixis colors, but well, this is what we are trying out now. Another card I think is pretty cool is Cast Out. This is like an instant speed Oblivion Ring that costs 1 more, but it has the upside that you can also cycle it if you don't need it. Or if there is like again a matchup where you won't find a permanent, which should be pretty rare actually. Maybe like this Ral Storm Lotus deck or what have you. Yeah, then you can just cycle it for 1 mana, again fill the graveyard up for the dig through time here, and it's a nice alternative to remove Planeswalkers, since there is nothing really else in these colors, unless you counter it on the stack, of course. But once like the opponent resolves a Teferi or what have you, well, then you need the Cast Out to get rid of that. And last but not least, we have Sealway here, which is another nice 2-mana removal that you can flash in. So it instant speed again helps against the haste creatures that your opponent might draw from the top, and it also helps against manlands. And yeah, it gets exiled until the Sealaway leaves the battlefield. So again, if you also play against the Phoenix deck, well, you have now 4 a little bit more overpriced paths to exiles that you know from Modern. But I think this is always pretty good to have in the deck, and I think I didn't, these cards didn't come to my mind before, so I'm happy that I found this list. Again, credits to the creator, of course. And yeah, then we have our finisher packet. We have talked a little bit about the Dixo Time already. Well, it's one of the most powerful spells ever printed in blue, I guess. There is a reason why this card is banned in Legacy and also in Modern. And yeah, as the game drags on, you will definitely reduce this casting cost to blue mana, and then you can look at the top 7 cards of your deck at instant speed and grab whatever cards you find there. So this is a pretty strong spell, and we have a lot of cheap spells to fill this. We want to interact with our opponents, and as we do, this will naturally get online. Then we have some Teferi Time Reveler. Well, as there is Oko dominating Modern right now, Teferi is put somewhat in the background in this format, but this is one of the most obnoxious planeswalkers printed in 2019 because, well, the static ability says we are playing Hearthstone 9 now, so no more instant speed stuff. And yeah, I guess bouncing something back and drawing a card is good. If nothing else, you buy a few life points in bouncing back, maybe, I don't know, a Swift Spear or what have you, so they have at least to spend a mana and attack the Teferi or whatever. But if it sticks, well, then you can create instant speed Supreme Verdicts, which can then also kill like a Mutavault or something. This is really strong. But I guess anything else in the deck is already instant, so the plus up is not that big of a deal. And the minus three, there is unfortunately no Astrolabe that you can bounce off our own deck or something like that. Or like a Snapcaster Mage or Icefang Kotal. There's no good ETB creature here, so I think the Teferi is not that strong as I remember it from Modern. But it should still be fine. If nothing else, it's a bounce spell and stops the opponent to interact with us, so could be nice. Maybe two is also correct, but yeah, since I'm only running a copy paste of the creator's deck list, well, let's run it like it is. And yeah, we have two Narsets here. Well, she has yeah, if you don't count the first Narset, 34 hits in this deck, which is ridiculously high, so she should always hit something. The static ability is pretty nice against the Phoenix deck, and yeah, it's again card selection. I like it in this deck. It's a nice 3-drop that will draw more cards. We have an Jace Architect of Thought, which is an actual win condition here, because if you reach the ultimate, you get the most expensive spell of our deck and of the opponent's deck, which in our case would be like a Teferi, Hero of Dominaria or Dig Through Time, depending on what we need. And the plus one is nice against these goblin tokens, for example, because yeah, they lose one attack point. You can't stop this goblin with Mentor because then the tokens become stronger over time, but against the Revel Master is definitely nice. And yeah, if nothing else, he is another source of card advantage. And yeah, same thing for Teferi, Hero of Dominaria. The ultimate will definitely win you a game over a few turns because you exile all the lands and then they have no mana sources to do anything. And the plus yeah, is still pretty nice. You draw an extra card, you can untap two lands to hold up some of these counters. And minus three is still board interaction, so pretty solid card. High loyalty, that's what you want from your planeswalkers. And yeah, this is like the win condition slot right here. That's why I have ordered it like that. And for the last spells, some opts to round out what we actually draw. It's yeah, probably the best or only real card selection you have for one mana in this format. And of course, it's another cheap fuel for the Dig Through Time. So yeah, I guess it's good for running out the numbers. Not running out, but you know what I mean, right? My English is still bad. yeah, then talking about the lands, well, we are running 25 because yeah, our curve goes up to 5 here, and no brainstorms or ponders, so you have to run more lands to actually draw them. But there are also some win conditions mixed into our lands. We have cast Castle Ardenvale. I hope I pronounce it correct. Yeah, this enters the battlefield tapped unless we control a plane. Well, we have several planes in our deck. And anyways, if we reach a later stage in the game and nothing happens at the opponent's turn, well, then we create just a 1-1 and can use it as an attacker or blocker. Then we have the blue equivalent, Castle Ventress, which for 4 mana can scry 2 cards, so we can dig better for these win conditions here, or for answers we are maybe needing. And the last nice win condition is if the opponent is in the top deck mode and we have Gaia Reach Sanitarium and a Narset in play, well, then in their upkeep you can make them draw a card. They then have to immediately discard it as a cost to this resolution, and then they can no longer draw a card in their draw step because Narset says each opponent can't draw more than one card. So at this point they are locked out, we are allowed to draw cards, and winning the game at this point is inevitable because we can either create 1-1 tokens or still have one of these other planeswalkers here to put the game away. Then we are coming to the real spice, and I haven't thought about this nice fellow since it was printed probably. It saw some modern play back then for maybe a few weeks, but then no one ever picked it up again, because in modern you have some other options, of course, in the 3 mana spot, and you've got the core Firewalker, I guess. But since mono red and mono black are the top dogs to beat right now, and this guy can't be removed by these colors, and he has a 2 power first strike, which is enough to kill all the goblins in the world, and well, he has also lifelink. This is a pretty good creature, I think. There were some Nyx Fleece Ramp, these sheeps. They are sheeps, right? Do I have them here? No. I've written them wrong. I will just show them in the video now at this point. I will just show the picture of this card right now. And this one is a 0-5 and gains a life, but the Fiend Slayer can actually go hunt for like an Chandra, what have you. Yeah, and with the first strike, well, if the opponent then tries to pump up like a Swift Spear or something and aims a spell at us, well, we can then use the removal, so should be pretty good. I'm eager to see how this plays, if it's really better than the sheep, but I trust the creator for now, because yeah, so far I liked what he has done, so he's more experienced. Then of course some Lyra Dawnbringer. Yeah, it's no Baneslayer Angel, which is the real slayer of the evil guys, but well, Lyra is still nice. Flying First Strike Lifelink on a 5-5 buddy should win any combat phase, unless you face the real big Eldrazi stuff. So it will definitely kill the Glorybringer, unless they exert it and use a removal spell then. So besides that, you should win any combat with Lyra. We have some Monastery Mentor, which can create an army of 1-1s. This is also another reason why you want some cheap cantrips. You run it out, if the opponent can't answer it, well, you get tokens that grow with every spell you're playing, and if you are playing maybe against this mono-green ramp deck, this is one of the strongest clocks I guess you can play, because these tokens can get out of hand pretty quickly. Then we have Ethergust, another card that I didn't notice before, and this allows you to counter or put back a permanent that is red or green. Green, another big color, of course, besides red and black, that is running around with this mono green ram deck. You can't, unfortunately, counter the Eldrazis. I guess that's where you have to use these kind of counter spells, but if it's anything else, like these other guys that were searching for land drops or what have you, then you can counter them. You can also use it as removal for the red creatures, for the Chandras, and yeah. Let's see how this will play out. It's like a dual mode counter spell, removal spell, just like the Drawn in the Locks that I liked from Grixis, so I think I will like them too. Well, some Mystical Disputes against blue decks, can't go wrong there. You definitely want to counter this Teferi, because this is the game breaker in the control mirrors. because then one opponent can't play half of his deck while the other one can. And yeah, it can also counter everything that's blue, so not only non-creature spells, but also creatures if that comes up. And last but not least, yeah, some Dovin's Vetoes can't be countered, counter target non-creature spell should be good against these Ral combo decks. But I have seen some nasty techs where they are using Fae of Wishes to get an uncounterable black spell from their sideboard, and then they can play this uncounterable black spell to get rid of all non-creature spells in your hand. So this is a nasty, nasty answer to the Dovin's Veto, and you have to counter this Fae of Wishes at all costs, because else you probably can't win the game anymore, and unfortunately you can't choose the spell with Ethergust. Choosing allows you to get around uncounterable, if I remember it correctly, because there is no line in here that says counter target spell, but you choose a spell, doesn't matter if it's on the stack or if it's a permanent in play, and then you put it back on top. So you could actually, yeah, even counter like an Aprobe Decay, or yeah, counter in quotation marks, right? But you can prevent an Aprobe Decay, for example, on an asset with this Ethergust. So this is something to take note of. And without further ado, let's test this baby out and hope we can crush the league so I get some tickets back from the horrible beating in Modern last night. And we will jump in. Borrow the 10 tickets and see how it goes. Hope it goes well. But I will probably make a cut again after the first round. Need to grab something to eat again. Yeah, it's always around 11 o'clock that I start getting hungry again. Don't ask me why, but that's the case anyways. And then we will finish the league after the cut. For you guys, it won't matter because you can watch the whole league at YouTube anyways, but yeah, if you wonder about the time, well, I cut it after this first match because of all the talking before. And of course, we have this trusted sideboard guide, which has Tear the Ramp. Yeah, I guess I can even show you the ramp in his previous list. Let me quickly show it, but yeah, anyways, the league starts, so I will just show it in the video. So, yeah, well, we have land drops, we have some mass removal, we have spot removal or a redraw, so I guess that's a keep. That's what you are looking for with blue-white, and we are facing the Phoenix deck, I guess? No, it's the Ensol Artifact deck. So I definitely want to cast the Azorius Charm on turn 2 probably to bridge into these mass removals. The Dixru Time will be our kind of finisher. We have to play around the Stubborn Denial, of course. So I guess this can enter is untapped unless we control an if we control an island. And this can be cycled later. So I actually either start now with the farmland and don't bother about the cycling, which I guess is fine with this hand. Or I play the Hallowed Fountain tap to prevent some life loss down the line. But I guess we need all these lands anyways to be able to cast this stuff, so let's play it out now and save us some tempo later on. Here comes Ensol probably. Yep, so we take our 6 damage already. And now we have to hope that they don't have the Stubborn Denial, because else it gets really rough, because usually they play like this spell where you sack an artifact and then deal as much damage as this artifact had power, I guess. And another Ensol. Well, this gets ugly now. So I guess we kill. Do we go to 8 or do we go to 9? I don't think there is much difference here. And I actually want to get this Beaumont Courier off the battlefield before he can make use of the card advantage, so I guess. Yeah, but then again, he will just redraw it, right? So never mind. Because this has haste. Can't we choose it? Choose target attacking or blocking creature. Yeah, well, I'm trying. So you can't, unfortunately, kill this guy. Because it's an artifact or what? That's odd. Oh no, it has protection for multicolored. Never mind. Didn't know that. First time coming up here. I'm so dumb. So we are going to 2 next turn, which is a huge deal. Well, so I guess I have to play this tapped if I want to ever use it somewhat. He plays the Bomad Courier and then we are going to 1, or he activates the Mutar Waltz. Wow, okay, that's a huge draw, but lucky. Yeah, let him exile the stuff, doesn't matter, and you can have the battle on top. Then we go to 2. And guess we let him attack for the settle. Because if we verdict here, he uses the Mutar Vault. Of course, he still has the Mutar Vault, so. Yeah. Looks rough. Any burn spell will kill us now. That's a really good start. So he has a Courier and 1 Unknown. Luckily for us, he goes in with the Mutar Vault. If we are unlucky, he has even a Stubborn Denial, but. Well. This is also fine. This is not uncounterable. And protection doesn't matter against the destroy everything. Ghostfire Blade. So this is now also rough. Because the Bomad Courier can kill us now, I guess. So. Yeah, we have to exile this. He plays like the Bomad Courier and then equips the Ghostfire Blade to it, I guess. Yeah, it was a rough start against 3 Ensoul Artifacts. Kindred Brute, okay. Yeah. Wow, he only attacks with 1 creature. Why does he do that? Doesn't make sense, kind of, right? Does he play around another settle? Well, probably. But if we now draw like a Teferi Time Reveler, we don't have enough mana, right? Well, if we exile the Ghostblade, actually. Is this an ability? I can't read this anymore. Let me quickly check it out. Ginger Brute. Ginger Brute. Sacrifice, you gain 3 life. Well, if we take the 1 damage, we go to 1 anyways, so I guess we might as well get rid of this dude. And we found the Time Reveler. But unfortunately, we are missing 1 mana to instant speed the Supreme Verdict. So that's really unfortunate. I guess what we can do is trying to dig for another spot removal here. This is rough. Found the Seal Away. And he can only play 1 card unless he draws a land. Okay, he equips there. And this is only protection from multicolored, so we can use the Seal Away, actually. And what a close game. What a close game. Maybe we were lucky that he actually played around the Settle the Wreckage, the second that he thought we would have. And now, since we can instant speed Supreme Verdict, we should be pretty good here. We can use this Field of Ruin to blast one Mutar War that comes down the line. And we can soon use the Dig Through Time, I guess. He has still a Bomard Courier in hand. That's something to take note of. So, if we use the verdict now, we still have to find an answer, but I guess we are kind of forced to use the spell here. And unfortunately, we have now 4, 5, 6, 7. We are missing one card, right? 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 8. Yeah, unfortunately, we have... Well, this is at least a hope to survive. Now he will play the Courier, I guess. Yes. Then he will probably equip. One more unknown card. Always hoping that he doesn't have this Stubborn Denial. That we can now find Sheep Spot Removal. But we have a lot of looks, so... Let's try this. He can't interact because of the Teferi. So let's use the open mana for maybe getting like a verdict. This is rough. Didn't found the verdict. So I guess we have to take the opt. And take like the absorb afterwards so we can get back up some life totals. Huh, interesting. We can bounce back the seal away next turn to get the enchantment back, so... Well, that doesn't matter, I guess. Then we have to dig for the next two cards and hope there is a removal there. So, only one unknown. Ah, you know what I should have done? I should have countered my own opt with the absorb. Then I would have gained the life we needed here. This was dumb. Yeah, should have countered my own spell withholding the priority. I guess that was the right line. So this one goes on me. Sorry. Was maybe kind of an unusual line. So let's see. Do we have Ensoul? Yes, he brings in Lyra, the ram that we don't have anymore, and Dispute. I think Dispute makes sense because of Ensoul Artifact, which killed us this game. So we want the Dispute, and we want the Lyras, but we don't have the Rams anymore, so... Oops. No life gain there. And he brings out the Narset as Absorb and Syncopate, which... I guess makes sense. And the Syncopate for sure. That is also not good, so what can we bring in instead of Absorb? Well, Dovin's Veto is somewhat cheaper. There are... Well, bouncing or preventing this Galvanic Blast could be okay, but you can also do this with the Veto and they can't prevent it, so in this case Veto is better. The first strike is too weak, or the two power. If we are correct, the Mentor could be nice because you can at least block with the tokens somewhat, so maybe we go like this. Still like Spell Pierce, so let's try it out. Man, I'm dumb. I should have countered my own opt. I should have countered my own opt to be sure. Was too greedy there. Well, opt into Charm. Guess we kind of have to keep that. We can cycle the farmland down the line because we already have perfect mana here, so this is more like a cantrip now. Unless we really need land drops. And the courier, okay. Take our one damage, I guess. And Then use the opts. Don't need more lands right now. Dispute is not bad. So let's keep up the charm. And let's see if he does play something. If not, we can cycle the farmland. But I'm pretty sure he's playing a spell. That's what his deck does. Yep. Gingerbrood. Unfortunately, they all have haste, so... Yeah, whatever. Let's get rid of the courier, so his cards are lost. And we found a Lyra, so this is now like an finisher. And at this point, we might want to use this farmland, because it's a fifth land drop, so... No, we still have Dispute and Charm up. We don't care about one damage right now. And I guess we can dispute that. Well, at this point we don't need the farmland anymore, so... yeah. Land go, huh? Still having two cantrips or removal and one cantrip? Or, yeah, a redraw. Let's not call it a cantrip. And the Lyra to finish the game. Here comes the Ensoul, but that is fine because we still have the charm. That is why I like the charm in this deck. He has a courier still in the hand, I guess. And... maybe he has a counter here. No, he has not, so we take one. And let's cycle this land, actually. Well, found another land drop. That's fine. And at this point, well, we just slam the angel and hope for the best. Maybe he has another Ensoul, but at this point we can race him, probably. And just opting for an unknown doesn't feel right here. Okay. We play defense now. And see what our opt can hit. He doesn't have any good attacks now, with a Lyra in play. And he attacks anyways. This is interesting. Ah, okay, because we can't block. Sure, makes sense. That makes sense, so I guess there is no merit in... yeah, well, keeping the Lyra back forces him to always tap these guys. But if we attack, well, all of these guys, yeah, attacks are pretty much nullified. I guess we can opt here first and see what we hit. Don't want the land. Yeah, Field of Ruin is not bad. Let's attack here. Now, do we dig through time in this turn? We have 6 in the graveyard and can do it for 2 mana. I guess in case we hit like a Teferi or something, might still be fine. And I like the removal here. I'm unsure about the Supreme Verdict, but I guess if something gets really out of hand, we can use the Verdict to clean up here. So I don't hate it as an emergency out. And I guess we can still take the seal away in case he has another Ensoul, because we will win this race, I think. Or we try to get rid of this Whirler. Yeah, let's see, maybe if he attacks we can get rid of the Whirler. I like this more. The Mentor has no real value here, and the Jace is only another redraw. I think we want more impactful spells. A nice thing is that he has no real good top decks at this point. Yeah, only some more couriers, but he has no hand anyways, so... If he sacrifices them, it's also fine. Well, we could now just use the verdict and clean up everything. But then he uses the couriers, so I guess I don't mind. This is 2-4. 2-4-6-7. Well, in the end, we only are taking 2 damage per turn, so whatever. Still fine. We keep this in case he draws an insult. Well, now we found another verdict. That's not ideal, but yeah. Think he can't beat this Lyra. And if he can, we are still pretty alive. Okay, now he wants to block with his top toss, I guess. Okay. Well, he can draw more gas with these couriers, that's for sure. Let's kill the Mutavault here. Grab another planes, then use the Ventress, and I don't need either of them. Well, if he doesn't attack with everything, then our life total stays high, so don't hate that. Want to dig for the settle the wreckage here. There comes an ensoul. Okay, sure. This point, I can't prevent them anymore. Maybe I should have verdicted, but. He didn't attack with this after all, that was dumb. Yeah, let's get rid of that so he has some spells again. Some misclicks here. Now he gets back his hand, I guess, okay. Now he kind of wants to finish us. I don't hate the Teferi here. Let's do this like this. We want to plus him. Maybe. Yeah, let's see what he does. He has at least only 4 to 5 mana now, so he needs to still leverage all his cards with the mana. Yeah, first thing he gets rid of Lyra, which is okay, so we can use Verdict again. And we still have 2 planeswalkers in play, so he can only kill the Teferi here. Yeah, okay. And we found the Arden Whale. How much do you have? Ah, you have to use energy. It's a vehicle for 3. Let's use the Jace Miners and grind on, I guess. Found another Tefri, so we are choosing Pile 2, I guess. And a new order again. Lay the Arden Whale. And then cast out, not bad. So let's see what he's doing now. Here comes another courier. Sure. Okay. Okay. Maybe I should have casted this in response to the blade equipping, so he can't use stubborn denial. But well, take off the vehicle in the back, because we can kill these two with the verdict. And at this point, verdict only costs 2 mana, thanks to the Teferi. And we found the Sanitariums, which is not bad. So let's use one of this, and yeah. Let's get rid of the Whirla, I guess. And yeah. Soon we can block for days here with our Castle Adden Vale, so slowly getting this Teferi up to 8 is the goal here. Still have lots of removal here, and a blocker, I guess. Well, let's see what he's doing. Of course, he only has one more card in hand, so we have pretty outgrinded him. Like, you can go back on top. If I tapped wrong, I have tapped wrong. Never mind then. We need double white. I'll do it like this. So he draws a Mutar Wall next turn, which he can't really use. So. Okay, this one has flying. This is annoying. But we found a Seal Away, so never mind, I guess. And we found another castle. This one has flying, so yeah, I will get rid of it with the Seal Away then. And we just create more tokens to kill this other Mutar Vault. He draws a Mutar Vault, so. Slowly going to the Teferi ult, yes, and we win here. Could have played it better. Also the first game, of course, but well, now we have a third game at least. And still liking all of this. Not sure about the Mentor actually, because we want to wrath the board so badly. That I think that Mentor is not really needed. So at this point, I guess the Vitor is better than the Absorb, because it's one cheaper. And Maybe one mentor is fine after we have cleaned up. Ah, this feels kind of awkward because this castle is still good enough for the late game to create tokens, so guess we go with this. Maybe you can make an argument for Narset because she digs for more answers, and I guess I like that more. At least than the absorb, so she can't find Lyra, of course, but yeah. Should still be okay. This is a good hand. We take a damage, of course, from our land, but we have Dispute and opt up to prevent the turn 2 and soul, or a Ghost Fire Blade or what have you, and then we have a Seal Away to follow it up. If we draw a basic, that would be great. So we go to 17. Of course, we need to hit more land drops. That's for sure. If he plays no blue spell, then we use the opt to dig for more mana. And he plays something blue. Oh no, we can't prevent this, okay. Okay. And another seal away. I don't mind that kind of. But I want to hit land drops. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I guess I have to shock here, unfortunately. Taking quite some damage, but we need the removal. Yes. So I guess we take the 2 damage here, even if it hurts after we shock this in, but can use like an ensoul if we now use the mana as for the removal. So let's opt here. We need the land drop badly. Well, at least we have a redraw. Need it badly. Yeah, at least we found the land. I guess that's something. He can now use the mana for the hangar bug, of course. And we can't Teferi yet, so in this turn we are trying to use our removal spells and hold up the dispute. But he has a good start, that's for sure. Let's use the seal away actually. Don't want this courier to get back, so we only take 1 damage here. I want to get deeper into the deck, so I use the Teferi as here, just dying. Die and buy some life. What's that? Is this like a musical dispute? Oh, he is. Okay, yeah, at this point I kind of want to use my counter spells. Now he has, of course, the option. Yeah, that's what I thought. So we have to be careful now. This has haste anyway, so. Well, we could be dead here. It's definitely the case if he has an ensoul, but luckily he doesn't, so. He attacks me, maybe he has another shrapnel blast. But it's hard to counter both shrapnel blasts down the line, so yes, I guess Since we needed to chalk in these first two lands, that was kind of rough here. That was definitely not good. But all in all, I guess I lost the matchup in the first game. I shouldn't have died in this turn, and then we have drawn, would have drawn a Time Reveler. Yeah, I wasted the first game. That was the unfortunate part. I mean, he had an insane start, of course, with three and soul artifacts. That was, of course, ridiculous, but we still made it close somewhat, so yeah. This loss is more on me. So this is the downside of the white removal, unfortunately. While it is very strong, it is costly. It's no cheap fatal push or something like that, so that's what you are paying in the tempo matchups. Supreme Verdict would have been great there, of course. So if we don't tap out for the Teferi, well, we have Charm up and the Dispute. Yeah, maybe that was right. Oh, not enough lands. I guess two lands and an Opt is good enough. I'm unsure what we are playing against, and I feel like I don't want the Teferi. We have enough win conditions in the deck, and I kind of want to survive, so I guess we go with the rest. The cast out can be cycled, so I like this actually. We will draw another win condition eventually, even if there are no fetch lands. Well, unfortunately, we have to play that in tapped. Seems like a mirror match or something. Yes. So the first one who resolves the Time Reveler probably wins. Luckily we have a cast out, but we are not on the play, so... What? Found a Spell Pierce. Would you look at that? Spell Pierce might save the day. Yep. That's also why Azorius Charm is nice. You can cycle it in matchups like these. And here he goes. Probably. Can't resist the turn 3 Teferi, right? So we slam our Spell Pierce, just like we have drawn it up. Unfortunately, now we don't have the third untapped mana, so I guess we play the castle and hope that we can cast out whatever he plays now. Maybe he doesn't have a follow-up. It's not like this deck has infinite win conditions, so... Don't hate the land, actually. Land drops in these control mirrors are pretty important. And we found another hero, so... do we shock this in? I guess yes. The two life don't matter. Yes, it's no cryptic mana, but now we can use the cast out. If we resolve something good. Okay, that's also fine. Next turn we can actually then scry at end of turn, which is also pretty good. Maybe we should have created tokens first, but I figure going with the scry is also good. No rush in the token here. There's a serious win condition in these control mirrors. And I don't feel like there is anything I really worry about. If he digs through times, yeah, well, he digs through times. We still have enough stuff here going on. And we found a Time Reveler of our own. I definitely take that. And guess we just pass the turn. Because the first one that moves usually loses, and with the token we can now pressure him somewhat. Make a little army here. And if he moves, we use the Time Reveler to punish him. And still have Absorb up, so that's good. Here is coming something. A Narset. Well, might as well use the absorb now. Kind of worked, that's surprising, so I guess we can try out the Time Reveler then. Guess that's good now. But I actually want to lead with Big Tef first. Because I feel like the coast is clear at this point if he doesn't fight for the absorb. Okay. Wow. Didn't expect that. Why wouldn't you try to force Narset through then? Doesn't make much sense, because you already have the Sanatorium for a nice combo. Yeah, well, no, he plays one of his own. That's bad, of course, for us. Three unknown here. Do you have another one? Okay. And the Time Reveler sticks, so we immediately plus it to redraw. Seal away is bad, unfortunately. We kind of have to get rid of this Teferi now. Can't counter, of course, but might cast out of his own. These are bad now. They are stuck in my hand, doing nothing. I hope he has also some Supreme Verdict, so what have you? Yep. Now I want the Ventress again to look for better top decks. Might as well do it in my upkeep. Oh yes, okay. That's good. We can get rid of the Settle, I guess. And he has more lands. And let's scry something more relevant here. And we found the Architect of Thought, which is a good top deck here, because he can't do anything about this, so we are slamming the Jace, that's for sure. Plus this, of course. Minus this. Wow, okay. Pile of counter spells. I will take two then. It doesn't matter what you are giving me. Choose pile one then, I guess. And yeah, now he has one turn to put something onto the battlefield. Or else I'm fine with whatever we are drawing. And then we start to creating tokens, so... Yes, so he can get back his big Teferi now. Well, he can get rid of this Teferi. Okay. This verdict doesn't do much here, fortunately. Want to keep this Jace around, so yeah, I guess he draws also some more cards now. We still have another cast out, of course, in our deck. goes to Jace, but we can redraw it pretty fast with the castle here. So I guess we are going to scry. And we also found a Nas set. This is really good against the Teferi, I like that. Then we minus and get back our Teferi. I will definitely pick the Teferi here. Not even close. Not even close. Let's try to stick it. Do we fight here or do we fight for the Narset? Because we can waste now one mana of his, of him. So he only has three other cards. But he still has the Teferi to go up, so might as well try to fight here. Absorb the absorb. Okay. Can't pay. Can't pay here. Let's hope he doesn't have a spell pierce or something. Or another syncopate for one. And Narset sticks, luckily, so his Teferi doesn't do anything for one round. He found an Azorius charm, which can at least cycle, I guess. Now we have two more time revelers in our deck. Our Gaea's Reach is unfortunately on the bottom, so the question is also now how to win, because at one point or the other we actually have to attack with something. So yeah, guess we make some tokens pretty soon. Because this Teferi can still go to ultimate, of course, so we found another Time Reveler, which is definitely nice. We can plus here. And yeah, then let's try to stick another one, right? Okay, we can get rid of the Seal Away. Come on. Yes, he sticks, so we could now get back our cast out and then cast out the Teferi. But then he gets it back, so can we counter it on the way down is the question, and I think the answer is no at this point. So I might want to plus it here, to be honest. But it's hard to resist the value, right? It's hard to resist the value. But well, we plus it here. I don't feel like putting him down right now. I want to counter this cast out on the way back, so if he uses a Teferi now, I'm fine with that too, and we can dig through time here, so Narset is nice here. Yes, you can resolve this. And then let's actually dig through time here. 2, 3, 6, 7. Pick something nice up. Can't do anything about that, like this absorb. And yeah, he concedes. At this point he is pretty much outclassed. I feel like we want to bring all the counters, of course. So Mentor, V2 and Dispute. And bring out our useless Steal Aways, of course. We want the V2s, we want the Disputes, and we want the Mentor, I guess. Let's quickly check it again. Yes, so these 7 cards, and then the settle and the verdicts also go out. There might be an argument to keep one verdict in because of his own mentors, but yeah, actually, let's do it like this. I think mentor is something to respect, and we still have the sanitarium to pitch it later on. And we also have Narset and Dictu time to grab this mass removal. So I feel like it's fine. Now it's really about the land draws, because Mystical Dispute is so strong in the early game. So I like that. I like this hand. We have lots of land drops, a syncopate to counter, the first big spell. And an Azorius Charm to cycle. And we have more resources since we are on the draw. And we found a Narset. It's already good to stick. And an Absorb. So we build up our counter wall. Yep, here comes the cycling. And here comes the mentor, so luckily I respect it and have also the verdict in the deck. And yeah, now let's try to punish him with this Narset, I guess. Or stick a mentor of our own. Well, would you look at that? Let's see if he did respect the mentor. Yeah, seems like our decks are pretty identical. And he has a Teferi, but this is only buying time. We can still put it back into game. Because there's nothing to fear at one mana. So yeah, try to deal with his mentor, my friend. If he has now like a big Teferi, well, that is good for him, but we can't counter that anyways anymore, so... he needs like a fifth land and a big Teferi. And seems like he got it. Yep. That's rough, that's rough. And at this point it's GG, probably. That went from really well to pretty rough. Just a few turns, so... maybe I should have held up the Absorb, but I felt like... this was the only out he had to the mentor, and he had it, so... yeah, unfortunately there's not much we can do here. Because our counter spells are kind of dead. We can play the Narset here, but it's still hard to stick anything because of his Teferi. Well, a Teferi of our own would have been good if we have one land more, so... unfortunately we were on the draw, so that's bad this time. I should have cycled this because I can't do it in his turn. That was also dumb. Making misplays here. Well. Does he have another counter spell? That's the question. Sensor is not good enough. The fairy doesn't draw a card. So he needs an syncopate or an absorb. Let's try it. And he has a counter spell, so not much we can do here. Unfortunately. He also has the Gaia Reach lock that will eventually grind us out at this point. Well, too far behind. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have run out my own mentor after he ran out his, but unless he has small Teferi into big Teferi, I feel like this line would have won the game on the spot. And you only have two big Teferis in your 60 card deck, but yeah, well, he did draw it, so nothing to do there, and now we are missing land drops, and suddenly the cookie crumbles again. Sometimes this game really hates me, so well, I like most of the stuff. We can maybe risk putting the third land back, because we have an opt, but we can also put the opt back, because there's not really anything I'm looking for here. We have all the tools we need. And try to stick this mentor at turn 3, like he did. Let's see how this will go. He needs exactly the syncopate. Feels like a reversed matchup if we draw the small Teferi and the lands. We can hold on for this after we draw the mentor actually, but let's see. Let's cycle for now. That's also fine. So let's get this down before he has dispute up. He needs a syncopate now. And seems like he has it again. Nope, okay. Now he needs a mentor of his own, or again, the Teferi line. He needs something now. Because if we can untap with this mentor, well, now I feel we have won the game, kind of. Even if he has another Azorius charm, I don't care. I just counter everything he does right now. So, what are you gonna do? The mentor is coming. Guess for now he does nothing, which is fine by me, because our hand is stacked like hell. Supreme Verdict would be okay for him. And now the mentor begins. Always yes. Always yield. Wow, and even a veto. Now I will hold on for the syncopate in case he plays his own mentor, I guess. Opting here is fine. Well, let's get rid of that. This was a good draw, so now we have double absorb up. Yes. I think this is not worth countering at this point. Just for us for 7 damage. If it would have been lethal, well okay, but still feel pretty good here. I will probably activate the Ventress end of turn. because we don't need the token right now, but we want drawing better cards. So let's use this. Well, dispute and veto. I don't mind the veto. Don't like the dispute. So he soon has to activate this to make a token. To create blockers. But he scries, okay, maybe he's digging for a supreme verdict. I feel like in his position making a 1-1 is not bad, because you can trade either with the monk tokens or, yeah. Try to create blockers for this mentor, and he has one of his own, so this is a time we fight. And if I can make tapping him out, should be pretty good. Because we still have this army here. Now he can still counter the absorb, of course. But we still have a lot of damage here. So I don't mind attacking with everything, because then he has to block, kind of. And we still have all these counters, so... Yes, you can have your mentor. You have to block my mentor now, and... Well, this is then the easy win. Now he can't even trade, and we have one. Yes, good. So I will make a break here. I hope to see you later down the road. This deck is a lot of fun. And yeah, it puts some good games of Magic in there. It wants to interact. It can interact. Well, if the opponent doesn't want to interact, we can cycle most of our removal spells. It's well constructed, that's for sure. And yeah. Let's hope that we win some more matchups, so that I get at least some tickets out of this. And yeah, I mean, if I would have been a little bit better, or pay more attention, or talk less, and concentrate more on the match, whatever the case, I guess we could have won this first round too. So yeah, thank you for watching so far, and hope to see you in the next part. Yeah, bye bye.